Welcome to day four of competition here at the 2017 Summer Universiad in Taipei. We'll kick off today's highlights at the Taiwan Sports Arena with both men's and women's swimming finals. First up was the men's 50-meter butterfly race, where eight athletes qualified for the final. The Universiad record for this event was set back in 2009 by Kenya's Jason Dunfor with a time of 23.09. Keep your eye now on lane four. That is the Ukraine's Andrei Govorov, nicknamed the Ukrainian Rocket. Now, he competed at the 2012 Olympic Games, and he will look to break the Universiad record here again today. You can see his hands just falling short of that world record, but as he approaches the end, he finishes with a time of 22.9 and breaks that Universiad record from back in 2009. The Ukrainian athlete wins the gold medal. The Russian athlete, Andrei Zelkin, he gets the silver, and Brazil's Henrique de Souza Martins wins the bronze. Now the athletes competing in the men's 100-meter backstroke take to their starting positions. Lane four must have had some luck in it. Keep your eye on Justin Ress of the USA. Ress has already won a gold in the men's 4x100 freestyle relay, and he would go for the gold again today. He will also compete at the 4x100 medley relay. Ress in the lead after the first length. The world record way ahead, but he will end with a time of 53.29, good enough for the gold medal. The silver medal will be awarded to Japan's Kosuke Hagino. He's a four-time Olympic medalist, including a gold medal in the 400-meter medley in the 2016 Olympics. And the bronze medal will go to the Lithuania's Danis Repsis. Next up, the women got into the water with the 50-meter butterfly race. Eight athletes from around the world competed in this final, and there must be something about that fourth lane. This time, it was Germany's Elena Schmidt who was in that lane, and she took the gold as well. You can see she had the lead almost the entire race. Seconds into this one, you can see she is clearly ahead. It comes down to the wire, but she finishes the race with a time of 26.16. She captures the gold in this 50-meter butterfly race. It's Italy's Elena DeLido who wins the silver, and the bronze is awarded to Japan's Yukina Hirayama. Germany's Schmick, the athlete who represents Ohio State University in the United States of America, picks up her first medal at a Universiad. Next up is the men's 100-meter breaststroke. Now this one comes down to a very, very exciting ending. Keep an eye on lane six and lane five. That's the Belarus's Ilya Szymanowicz and the USA's Andrew Wilson. At the first length, you can see in lane five, it's the USA's Andrew Wilson who has a bit of a lead, but Szymanowicz makes a huge comeback in this last stretch. Approaching the end, we'll get five and six. Touch the wall at the exact same time. Both athletes from Belarus and the USA end with a time of 1.15. Take another look. They will both be awarded gold medals in this race, and the bronze will go to Kazakhstan's Dmitry Balandin. We'll finish the swimming finals now with the women's 200-meter backstroke.
Three.
This race would last over 2 minutes long, and it came down to the wire between Australia's Sean Monique Whitaker, Canada's Alexia Vesnik, and USA's Bridget Alexander after the first length. It was the Canadian athlete who pulled ahead with a time of 30.41 seconds. She lost that lead after the second length, falling to the second spot as USA's Bridget Alexander wins that one with a time of 1 minute and 2.91 seconds. Alexander was able to keep the lead in the third length, 1 minute 36.19 seconds, but Australia's Sean Monique Whitaker kicked it into high gear on this last length. The Aussie won the race with a final time of 2 minutes and 9.5 seconds. Canada's Alexia Vesnik came in second, won the silver medal with a time of 2 minutes, 9.92 seconds. You can see just came down to a sliver there as the Australian athlete picks up the gold. Canada wins the silver and the USA's Bridget Alexander wins the bronze. Let's head out to a drier venue now to recap men's and women's fencing finals at the Nangang Exhibition Center. The men's FA individual gold medal match got underway between Russia's Sergei Bida and Hungary's Zsombor Bagné. Bagné able to score the first point with a touch to Bida's midsection with 2:26 on the clock during the first period. On to the second now. Bida came back scoring a quick 4 points as he attacks and gets his fifth touch to the face. Bagné though battles back with a touch, followed up with another to have the score at 6-3. A nice attack by Bagné there gets Bida one more point. Great defense by the Russian athlete. It is now 10-6 for Bida. Bagné gets one more in the final period in this bout, and he's disagreeing a little bit with the referee. 11-10 now. He scores one more with a touch to the midsection. It's 12-10, Bida over Bagné. 23 seconds to go. Bagné battling back, but Bida pulling it out once again with 10 seconds. It's 13-11. Bida scores once again. And as he reaches 15, shows the audience his muscles, and he's going to take the gold medal in the men's épée individual. This is Sergei Bida's first medal at a university, and he pulls out the gold. He will also compete in the men's épée team event later in the Universiade. Bida Sergei from Russian Federation. Sergei Bida won the gold. It was Bagné in the silver, and athletes from Japan and Poland won the bronze. The final of the women's foil event followed between Hungary's Fanny Kreis and Russia's Yana Alborova. This would be a quick bout between these two athletes as Kreis gets on the board quickly first with a 3-1 lead to kick it off. She quickly jumps up to an 8-3 lead. And again, remember that these go to 15. So the bout almost halfway over now. Kreis, 9-3, gets another one. She's in double digits. 1 minute, 22 seconds left to go in the first period. She gets one more point on the board. She's sitting at 14 now, looking to end it here. An attack by Alborova gets Kreese the last point, and she wins the gold medal of the women's foil event here at the 2017 Summer Universiad in Taipei. Kreese had an absolutely dominating tournament here in Taipei, scoring 15 points at every game she played, never letting the time run out. Back in June, Fanny Kreese placed 26th at the World Championships and has now come out on top with the gold medal over Russia. She will go on to compete in the team foil event on August 24th.
Women's foil individual.
Now over to yesterday's weightlifting event at the beautiful Tam Kang University Memorial Gymnasium. 12 athletes competed in the women's 58-kilogram event, including Taipei's Hu Xiangcheng, a two-time Olympian who also won the bronze at the 2016 Olympic Games. Winning the bronze medal in this event was the Democratic People of Korea's Chung Sim Kim with her combined total of 90 kilogram snatch and 127 kilogram clean and jerk. Her total was 217 kilograms.
Good leap. 成功.
Both of her lifts were less than this athlete, though, from Thailand, Sukanya Srisrat. She snatched 100 kilograms and in her final attempt here with the clean and jerk was able to successfully lift 121. In her third attempt, she did try and get up 123, but was unsuccessful. So she would end with 121 in the clean and jerk for a total of 221 total. Next up was the Olympian that people were here to watch. Kyo Seung Chun came to the stage. She had already set a record for the snatch at the Universiads with 107 kilograms, and that's why the crowd was going crazy. Earlier, she had already set the Universiad record for clean and jerk as well with a 136 kilogram lift. Now, with 142 on her bar, she goes for the world record, and she is successful. The Taipei athlete just broke a world record with 142 kilograms clean and jerk. With her snatch and clean and jerk total of 249, that's also a new Universiad record. She'll take home the gold medal with a total of 249. The Thailand athlete wins the silver, and with the bronze, it's the athlete from the Democratic People's Republic of Korea. After breaking the Universiad record for the snatch, the Universiad record for clean and jerk, and the Universiad record for overall total, as well as the world record for clean and jerk, it's a proud moment for this Taipei athlete to do in front of a home crowd.
For woman 58 kilograms, please be seated. And now it is the time for photos.
The first artistic gymnastics event ended last night with the women's team events, which took place at the Nanyang Exhibition Center in Taipei City. Each team consists of 5 gymnasts who compete individually in the vault, uneven bars, beam, and mat for a combined team score. Their individual scores will help qualify them for the individual events later in the competition. Starting it off, Japan's Asuka Teramoda earned a team-high 14.45 on the vault. Her teammate Yuki Uchiyama added a score of 13.7 from the uneven bars. They would help earn their Japanese team a bronze medal in the team event with a total of 159.9 points. It was Team Canada's Brianna Tsang now who took to the mat for an inspiring performance that would earn her team a score of 12.55 after a 1-point penalty. Despite the 1-point penalty, Team Canada sat in the number 6 position right now, but it was Canadian Olympian Ellie Black who propelled her team to the number 2 spot to earn the silver medal. She won almost every category here for Team Canada. You can watch her now on the uneven bars. After that incredible performance, the crowd goes wild and she sticks the landing. Canada finishes with the silver medal. Next up was Russia's team performance, which was almost done to perfection as Daria Elizarova took to the beam. Incredible precision by the Russian athlete as you watch her just absolutely stick the landing there. Now her teammate Daria Spiridonova went to the mat performance and was just as stellar, helping her earn Russia the top spot in this performance. Spiridonova won the silver medal at the 2016 Olympic Games for the team event as well. She was also the 2014 world bronze medalist and a 2015 world champ on the uneven bars. Russia ended the women's team final with a total of 163 and grabbed that gold medal. Team Canada earned the silver, and it was Team Japan that scooped up the bronze. For the individual all-around in this team event, it was Canada's Ellie Black that took it at the top spot with a total of 56.05 points. She qualifies for the individual events later today.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the...
We saw the Republic of Korea and Taipei men's athletes dominate the roller sport time trials yesterday, and the women were no different. Two Korean athletes and one from Taipei earned the top three spots in the 300-meter race. Korea's Soyoung Shin of Daegu Arts University would compete first. Approaching the finish line now, the time is looking good, and she puts herself in the top spot, finishing the race with 26.57 seconds. But the hometown athlete Chen Yingchu would soon knock her off of that top spot. A great start for the athlete from Taipei. 10 seconds into the race, you can see already beating the time of the Korean athlete before her. As she comes around now the final turn, she approaches the finish line. It looks like she will be able to beat that first race, and she does. It puts her in the second spot with a time of 25.82. She would win the silver medal in this event. Now top competitor Yusiel An would finish the 300-meter race in a lightning-fast 25.805 seconds to claim the top spot. Watching her, you can see how fast she is going around the track, absolutely sprinting at 110% the entire time. 22 seconds now in the race. She crosses the finish line and is done again with a time of 25.805. Good enough for the gold medal in the 300-meter women's time trial race. Two Korean athletes take the gold and the bronze, and it's a Taipei athlete that wins the silver. Both countries absolutely dominating this event, winning the 1, 2, and 3 spots in both the men's and women's events. We will head over now to the Taiwan University Sports Center for the men's volleyball matchup between Japan and Brazil. The first game for both of these teams at this summer Universiad. All volleyball games are sold out of this entire event. A nice little fake and pop by Japan's captain Taichi Fukuyama gives them an early lead in this one. Then a serve by Japan's Kenya Fujinaka is returned with a monster spike by Brazil's Wilson dos Santos to give the team a 2-point lead heading into the final stretch of the first match. At the set point, the score 33-32. It was a definite spike by Japan's Kenya Fujinaka that would win the match for his team. They went up 1-0. And although Japan went down in the second match early on, an out of bounds resulted in a tie game, once again sitting at 11-11. Now it stayed close the entire match, and at set point it was Brazil's Marcos Costa who served up an ace to tie it up at 1-1 apiece. It was close in the final game as well. 2-1, Brazil leads the way. Costa serve returned the spike, but blocked by the defense. It was able to keep it alive though, and it's now tied up at 2-2. Moving forward, the game tied at 7-7. A monstrous hit by Brazil's Dos Santos gives Brazil the lead. Watch it again. Right over top of the blockers, off the defense, and out of bounds. In the deciding play for Brazil, Japan fights back with a huge hit down the line by Japan's Imamura to keep his team alive. Brazil once again looking to close out the game with a long rally started with a spike from Dos Santos dug up by Yamaguchi. They went on the offensive once again, rejected at the net. Able to keep it alive though, back-to-back hits for Imamura. A quick mistake by Brazil allows another spike by Fujinaka, but it is blocked by Dos Santos to win the game. Brazil takes this one 3-2 over Japan. That's their first victory at this year's Summer Universiade. Team Brazil will move on tomorrow to take on the home city, Team Taipei.